name is Grace. Today I'm going to read the Bible story. Abraham's Journey. One of the descendants of Noah's son, Shem, was a man called Abraham. He grew up in a city called Ur, near the Persian Gulf. After Abraham married, he took his wife, Sarah, his father, Terah, his appended nephew, Lot, who he had brought up as his own son, to live in the northern city called Haran, were a bustling place full of wicked people, just like Abraham, who was a successful businessman, but only day out of the blue, Abraham heard God calling him. Abraham, I want you to live and grow to the country that I will show you. I am going to make you the father of great place people. I must have taken a lot of faith to do as God asked. Abraham sold the most of his person, packed up the rest, and set off with his wife on a long journey without really knowing where he have to go. But Abraham did. We sought question and talked Lot into coming to. Abraham brought flocks of sheep, goats, and cattle for himself and his nephew. He hired shepherds too, and brought camels and mules to carry tents, belongings, food, and water. After a week of peregrination, Abraham led his family and herd helpers away from everything they knew, moving in a huge train south. God led Abraham down into the land of Canaan, which is now called Israel. When Abraham reached a holy place called Shechem, he heard God's voice saying, "This is the country that I am going to give to your descendants. The stairs around was my steep field. He and his wife, Sarah, were well past middle age. And also, they had away longer. Away longer. For a family, they had never been able to have children again. Abraham tried not to question God, but to trust once more. They could not stay in Canaan, and there was a troubled famine. Is God guided? The family saw the desert to the lush land of Egypt. Here, food and water were plentiful, but Abraham found himself in quite another kind of trouble. Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, ordered the Sarah had to become on his waves. So God sent a trouble. This is the strength Pharaoh and his abhorrence until he changed his mind. And he soon let Sarah go. After that, Abraham left Egypt behind and hid north into Canaan again to that place called Bethel. There wasn't enough grassland for all the animals to graze on the Abraham's land. Lot's sheep began quarreling and fighting over it. There was only one thing for it. The two men slipped up. Lot went east into Jordan, there where he settled at a city called Sodom, while his uncle unpacked his tents and stayed in the countryside of Canaan. After Lot he had led, God spoke to Abraham again and repeated his vow. Look around you, he said, all this. Land, as the eyes can see, will belong to you and your family forever. And so Abraham waited and waited. Season came and went, but there was still no sign that he had Sarah would never have children. Over the years, God spoke to his several times, repeating his promise. It was always when Abraham least expected it. One night, Abram was sitting outside his tent as Unsel when he heard God said, "Look up, you will have a many distance as there are stars in the sky." Another time, after Abraham had made an offering to God, he had a terrifyingly real dream in it. God walked right next to him, vowing again that he would have a vast, weedly family, and that all the land for the river Nile to the river Euphrates would be theirs. As time went on, Sarah grew concerned that she would never be able to give Abraham a child. So she ignored her 86 years old husband to have a baby with her mind. Hagar and Abraham had a son called Ishmael. But rather than cheering Sarah up, it plunged her into sadness. Abraham turned 99 years old, and Sarah reached 90. And still they had no children for their own. However, God instead that his promise remind you, "I want you and your wife a child. Chang your naps as a sign of my woe," he said. "From now on you will not be Abraham and Sarah, but Abraham and Sarah do want, I say, and trust me, and everything I have told you, you will come true. You and Sarah will have your own baby next year. You will see. I want you to call him Isaac." So Abraham and Sarah continued to wait. Yes, today I read the Bible story. It was fun. Then, bye. Today I read Abraham's journey. Yes. Next time I read Kites of Sin. Yes, it was random. Bye.